Before time began, there was the cube. We know not where it comes from, only that it holds the power to create worlds and fill them with life. That is how our race was born. For a time, we lived in harmony. But like all great power, some wanted it for good, others for evil. And so began the war. A war that ravaged our planet until it was consumed by death. And the cube was lost to the far reaches of space. We scattered across the galaxy, hoping to find it and rebuild our home, searching every star, every world. And just when all hope seemed lost, message of a new discovery drew us to an unknown planet called Earth.
Thank you. Thank you. Gospel of Matthew, Jesus condemns the Pharisees for their desire to obey the law only to be seen of men, rather than truly obeying God's laws for the purpose of serving others and becoming better people. Jesus says, "They do all their deeds to be seen by others, for they make their phylacteries broad and their fringes long." The phylacteries refer to the command of the Lord given to Moses when he said, "Ye shall therefore lay up these words of mine in your heart and in your soul, and you shall bind them as a sign on your hand, and they shall be as frontlets between your eyes." A phylactery, or tefillin in Hebrew, is one of two leather boxes bound by a leather strap to the left hand and to the forehead during prayer, and containing four scriptural passages: Exodus 13, 1 through 10, 11 through 16, Deuteronomy 6, 4 through 9, and 11, 13 through 21. Each of these four passages commands Israel to bind the law to their heart and mind, symbolizing that the law should not just be rote actions, but instead part of our very soul. The head tefillin has four small compartments, each containing a scroll with one of the four passages of scriptures mentioned, and is bound to the head to symbolize that the law of God is always on the forefront of our minds. In the scriptures, the forehead represents what a person's thoughts dwell on, and therefore what he loves or desires. For the same reason, the Mosaic high priest wore an engraved gold signet on his forehead that read, "Holiness to the Lord." This was a reminder that his thoughts should always be holy, with the result that his actions would follow suit. The arm tefillin contains only one long scroll, with the four scriptural passages written one after another, and is bound so as to be near or pointed towards the heart, symbolizing that we do not just know the words of the law, but that the law has been revealed to our spirits through our heart. Modern arm tefillin are bound around the arm seven times, and also around the hand and middle finger, representing that the law is to proceed from our hearts, to our arms, down to our hands, becoming our actions in all that we do. The fringes or borders of their garments, or tzitzit in Hebrew, refers to the blue tassels tied to the four corners of their garments, and were meant to be a constant reminder of God's commandments. The Lord said unto Moses, "Speak unto the children of Israel, and bid them that they make them fringes in the borders of their garments throughout their generations, that ye may look upon it and remember."
My real name is Kevin Zaxor. I am the ambassador to New Planet Testing. People of Earth, since you did not return the space cache, your species and your planet is hereby forever blocked off and barred from the rest of the universe. Goodbye. We'll be right back.
the love of Lucifer, you will kill people in mass. The police will wear the black uniform of Saturn. The police will wear the black uniform of Saturn. The police will wear the black uniform of Saturn. The police will wear the black uniform of Saturn.
I've left QuakeCon. I'm going to be going back home. But I was visiting some of the old id Office locations. The new one, of course. They were kind enough to let me into their latest studio down in Richardson. I visited the Lake House, where quite a few of their classic games were created. I saw the original soft disk company. It wasn't technically id, but that's where a lot of it started. But for any of the Doom fans out there, of the classic Dooms, Doom 2016 was actually created in their Richardson office. But for any of the classic Doom fans, the building right behind me, that is the Black Cube in Mesquite, Texas. I'm going to switch the camera around. This is the Black Cube where the classic Dooms, and I believe up to Quake 1, were created. Look at that. The sky is even fiery red like hell just visiting this place. But this is where it all happened. It's called Town East Tower. It's out in Mesquite, Texas. Let me see if I can get some good shots of this. The sun is going down. I also wanted to visit the Plano office. That was the office that they used after this, I believe, where they started development on Quake 2 and whatnot. But this is the shrine. This is the temple where I've paid the pilgrimage to. I know I love every id game, but everybody knows Doom is my favorite of them all. I've dreamed for a long time of visiting this place. I don't know if it's occupied much these days. I see a leasing sign on it. I'm assuming they have people here during the work week. I do see a few office lights on and up in there. This is where the id Software 666 address was. And I got to see that id Software 666 tag over in the Richardson office. They kept it in a case. It's in my pictures a few posts down. We're going to do a quick walk around. And let me see here. Yeah, we're running out of daylight. I really wanted to do the Plano office, where Quake 2 and stuff was also created, Quake 3 on up. But we just don't have enough time. It's 30 minutes the other direction, I think. And unfortunately, that's way out of my way right now. I'll have to do that next year. But I got most of the offices. But yeah, here's the building right here, where all the classic Dooms were created. Everything that you love and know started right fucking here. Right fucking here. Like I said, I already did the Lake House, where they did some of the other older classic games like Keen and Wolfenstein. I went to Soft Disk. I can't remember if Wolfenstein was created here or not. Maybe that was the Lake House. I don't remember. I know they were also in Wisconsin for like a brief duration, some apartment in Wisconsin. Maybe that's where that went down. But this was Doom, all Doom development here, and I think Quake as well. Let's walk over here. What a beautiful fucking tower. And I'll tell you what, their office, their newest office over in Richardson, where they did Doom 2016, Quake Champions, everything else like that, also fucking incredible. Also fucking incredible. But this one, this has got history on it right here. This has got 20-something years of history on it right there. Make sure I get that nice and up close. I'm going to do another video with much clearer picture, because the streaming, I know, is crap. But, yeah, guys, that's it. That is it. It's where all of Doom started. That's where it was born. And I hope that you guys appreciate what came out of this place. I know that you do. We'll talk to you.
For something completely new, let's talk about time. Let's talk about Saturn. What you're looking at here is what's known as the magic square of Saturn. But one thing to note about the magic square of Saturn is that the number 45 is very relevant. Just look at that number. 4 plus 5 equals 9. And there's 9 numbered squares in this magic square. Not only that, as I said, there's 9 numbered squares. If you add 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 plus 6 plus 7 plus 8 plus 9, the sum is 45. Not only that, add the top row, add the squares at the top, you get 15. Middle row, you get 15. Bottom row, you get 15, and 15 plus 15 plus 15 equals 45. Not only that, the columns, look at the boxes off to the left. The three squares off to the left hand, you get 15. Add the middle column, 15. Add the right hand column, 15. 15 plus 15 plus 15, again, is 45. And once again, if you add the numbers 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 plus 6 plus 7 plus 8 plus 9, the sum is 45. Not only that, go to gematronator.com and you type in the words 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and you get the 45th prime number. Right? In reduced gematria, if you type in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, in reduced gematria, you get 197, which is the 45th prime number. And once again, if you add the numbers 1 through 9, the sum is 45. But look at this. Type in this phrase. The sum is 45 equals 1440 in Sumerian gematria. That's how many minutes there are in a day. Very appropriate for a video about time, right? That same phrase, the sum is 45 equals 93 in reverse reduced. 93, very significant number. The word Saturn equals 93 in ordinal gematria. But about this 197, minutes on a clock is 3:17, 3 hours 17 minutes. The word Saturn equals 3:17 in primes. Saturn is the 6th planet. Okay. Type into gematria of the 6th planet. In reverse ordinal, you get 197. Again, that number we talked about. But about 3:17, I'll link a video about how when you flip it upside down, it looks like the word lie. Even in gematria, type this in. The word lie flipped upside down equals 3:17. And I don't want to mince words, tell you which Bible verses and stuff, but there is a Bible verse out there that talks about how the father of lies is Satan. I'm just paraphrasing. Even in some horror movies you've heard of this. The father of lies, Satan. Satan can be equated with Saturn, not just because of the letters, though the letters are similar, Satan, Saturn. Look at this. Okay. The magic square of Saturn. Remember, each row sums to 15. 15 can be broken down to 6, 1 plus 5. There's 3 15s. 3 6s. When broken down, 3 6s. 666. Some people say those are satanic numbers.
Doors, dumb slap. Make it real dope, but love don't come with that. It feel like it though till you lose what you got. So let me talk to you till you understand and check. Let's get to know each other. I'm a CEO, I can meet your father. He'll be proud of you. I'm ill, I'm on the radio. I really rap, not a cat who just say dude. I'm on MTV, you seen from the hood. We got shit poppin', I've been around the world. When you suck, tacked out, make a smoke twirl. I bring you everywhere I go, you my dumbest girl.
No, I've tried and tried, still I can't get you off.